So here we have our completed stocks and dies, and it might be quite difficult to see on camera, but inside there is full of little offcuts of metal called swarf, and that needs to be taken out and cleaned because the swarf itself will damage the thread that we put in on the steel conduit with it. So that thread will be damaged by buildup of swarf, okay? So my learners are required to break down the stocks and dies into its elements in order to clean it. And these are the elements that we've got. So we've got the stock itself and the handles, and they're simply screwed into the side. Whole thing's often called the stock. So it's the handles added on. So we've got our stock itself. We've then got our guide we drop in. So the guide is dropped in next. It's important you get it the right way round. Some of my learners were trying to put it in that way round. We need the bolts themselves pointing up and our guide to be dropped into position like so. So our guide is in position. Next, we've got the actual die itself, the bit that cuts the thread. And again, they come in four common sizes, 16, 20, 25, and 32. We're using 20 mil ones, and again, it's got a little bit of swarf in there, and that would need to be cleaned out before starting the threading process. And you notice it has got two little recesses in there, and they're really important we get those the right way around. On the back side, you can see there is no recesses. So when we pull it up into position, we drop it in so we can see our two recesses there, and they line up with the bolts themselves, and then we just wind down the nuts. These nuts are not tightened off with a pair of grips, it's just tightened with the hand. And we've built our stocks and dies. Okay, so important things to remember to get round our die itself around the right way. It's 20 mil in this case, and to remove all the swarf inside in order that we can cut our thread onto our steel conduit.